भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय विन्नाय नमो नमः। हरे कृष्ण। So I am very pleased and I am feeling blessed to glorify Srimad Bhagavatam in presence of all the wonderful devotees of ISKCON Bhagavat Mahavidyalaya, especially senior Vaishnavas like His Grace Srivas Prabhu and His Grace Sankarshanitai Prabhu. And I seek their blessings that I can glorify Srimad Bhagavatam in a proper mood and in a proper way. Hare Krishna. So today we are reading the first chapter of 10th canto, verses 62 and 63. So first we'll recite the verses. You also recite word for all classes. So first we'll do the recitation and we'll read the purport.
Nandadhyaye vraje gopa यश्चामिषां च योषिताः वृष्णयो वासुदेवाद्या देवकाद्याय दुस्त्रियः सर्वे वै देवता प्राया उभयोरपि भारत ज्ञातयो बन्धुसुहृदो ये चेकंसम् अनुव्रताः।
सो द वर्ड फॉर वर्ड इज लाइक दिस। नंद आद्याः, बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम नंद महाराज, ये ऑल ऑफ विच पर्सन्स व्रजे इन वृंदावन, गोपाः द कवर्ड मेन, याः विच च एंड अमीशाम ऑफ दोज इनहैबिटेंट्स ऑफ वृंदावन च एज वेल एज योषितः विमेन वृष्णय मेंबर्स ऑफ वृष्णी फैमिली वासुदेव आद्यः हेडेड बाय वासुदेव देवकी आद्यः हेडेड बाय देवकी यदु स्त्रियः ऑल द विमेन ऑफ द यदु डायनेस्टी सर्वे ऑल ऑफ देम वै इंडीड देवता देवता प्रायः वर इनहैबिटेंट्स ऑफ हेवन उभयोः ऑफ बोथ नंद महाराज एंड वसुदेव अपि इंडीड भारत ओ महाराज परीक्षित ज्ञातयः द रिलेटिव्स बंधु फ्रेंड्स सुहृद वेल विशर्स ये ऑल ऑफ हुम च एंड कमसाम अनुव्रताः even though apparently followers of Kamsa. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. The inhabitants of Vrindavan, headed by Nanda Maharaj, and including his associate cowherd men, and their wives, but were none but denizens of the heavenly planets. O Maharaj Parikshit, best of the descendants of Bharat, and so too were the descendants of the Vrishni dynasty, headed by Vasudev and Devaki, and other women of the dynasty of Yadu. The friends, relatives, and well-wishers of both Nanda Maharaj and Vasudev, and even those who externally appeared to be followers of Kamsa, were all demigods. Purport. As previously discussed, the Supreme Personality of Godhead Vishnu informed Lord Brahma that Lord Krishna would personally descend to mitigate the suffering of the earth. The Lord ordered all the denizens of heavenly planets to take birth in different families of the Yadu and Vrishni dynasties and in Vrindavan. Now this verse informs us that all the family and friends of the Yadu dynasty, the Vrishni dynasty, Nanda Maharaj, and the Gopas descended from the heavenly planets to see the pastimes of the Lord. As confirmed in Bhagavad Gita, the Lord's pastimes consist of paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam, saving the devotees and killing the demons. To demonstrate these activities, the Lord called for devotees from different parts of the universe. So we were reading in previous few verses that how after the sons of Vasudev were born, he brought them in front of Kamsa because he had no other choice. He and Devaki were prisoners, and Vasudev had promised Kamsa that as my children are born, I'll bring them to you. Of course, Kamsa knew that he did not have any danger from the first seven sons or the first seven children. The danger was from the eighth one, who was going to kill him. So in the Acharyas of commentaries, we get very deep insights in this section. Vallabhacharya says that it's not that as soon as the sons of Devaki were born, they were immediately killed by Kamsa. So we read in the 59th verse that this son, whose name was Kirtiman, he was brought in front of Vasudev, in front of Kamsa by Vasudev. So Vallabhacharya says that this Kirtiman was actually the fifth child, and the first child was born 5 years back. So it had already been 5 years since the first child was born. He says that the proof is that proof that Kamsa did not kill the children as soon as they were born is that in Kshatriya families, the name-giving ceremony is done after the 13th day of childbirth. And in the first canto, we read that all the sons of Vasudev, they already had their names, like Kirtiman, Sushena, etc. So this was the fifth son, and Devaki was pregnant with the sixth child. And when Vasudev brought this Kirtiman in front of Kamsa, he said that he was very pleased with Vasudev's actions. He said that, please take him back. I'm not afraid of him. But yes, definitely the eighth child, I'm going to kill him. So Vasudev, he knew, as we discussed yesterday also, that Kamsa's words cannot be trusted. And the person whose mind is uncontrolled and who has a demoniac nature, his words cannot be trusted. So the nature of such a person is that he keeps on changing his mind. Today he will say one thing, tomorrow he'll say another thing. So you can't really trust them. So we see here that Vasudev's son is returned back to Kamsa. And it seems that now Vasudev will become happy that, oh, very good, Kamsa has left my son, bach gaya. But it's not like that. Vasudev already knew that this is not a reason for happiness, because Kamsa is not to be trusted, and definitely tomorrow he might change his mind and he'll come back and kill my children. So that's one thing that Vasudev was thinking in this way. Also, Vasudev is thinking that definitely my sons are saved, so definitely some happiness is being felt by me. But there is a problem with this happiness. If I become very happy, then the Lord's appearance will be delayed. Why is that? Because if Kamsa kills my sons, he tortures me more, he does more sinful activities, then the demigods are angry with him. And the demigods have already planned that the Lord should come as soon as possible, and for that the great Vaishnavas, Vasudeva and Devaki, will be tortured by Kamsa. This is their plan. So if there is a delay in this plan, something wrong is happening. So he was thinking whether I should feel happy or I should feel unhappy that the Lord's descent will be delayed. So he is also thinking that my name is Anaka Dundubi. When I was born, all the demigods, they were sounding their drums and kettle drums. You know, this is the ritual which demigods do when some great personality is born or something great happens. They play the drums and you can hear. So they played the drums because in Vasudev's family, or rather through Vasudev, Supreme Personality of Godhead would take birth. But now that is getting delayed. So Vasudev is very much detached from his sons. He is thinking that better that Kamsa would have killed my sons. This Vallabhacharya is explaining. So that the process of the Lord's descent will be accelerated. So sometimes we feel in our life that how to get detachment from material world. This detachment is not coming even after practicing devotional service for so long. So we get a very good hint here how detachment will come. Vasudev is detached from his own sons. He is thinking that it's better that Kamsa would have killed them. Why he is so much detached? Because he is eager for the Lord's appearance. He is eager to take darshan of the Lord. He is eager for the Lord to come in this world. So when we are also eager for the Lord to receive him in our heart, then detachment will automatically come. It won't come by external practices like hardcore tapasya. Or definitely tapasya is helpful in devotional service, but that is not the process. So we saw here that what is going through Kamsa's mind and what is going through Vasudev's mind. Now there is a third person involved. This person, he accelerates all the activities in the universe and he knows when to go to which person and talk what. So now Narad Muni enters in the picture, you know. And Narad Muni is thinking that why Vasudev is so happy? I don't like this, you know. So Vasudev should not be happy. Kamsa should torture Vasudev and Devaki more, so that his bank account of sin increases more and more, his Vaishnava aparad increases more and more, and the Lord becomes very angry and he wants to come fast. Generally, Lord is very merciful. So if someone does a little offense, the Lord thinks, okay, I'll tolerate it. But when it goes overboard, when it crosses a certain limit, then the Lord has to come himself. Otherwise, it does not come. He says, okay, no problem, I'll tolerate it. So Narad Muni is thinking now, what should I do to induce Kamsa to do more sin? So it seems that Narad Muni is doing something bad, you know, demoniac. Kamsa is becoming a good person, you know, he doesn't want to kill. Vasudeva is also happy. And now suddenly Narad Muni, who is a great devotee, actually in this verse the Bhagwan word is used in the previous verse 60 for Narad Muni. So he has all the six opulences which Krishna has in a lesser quantity. That is also explained by Acharyas here. So such a great personality, a pure devotee, and he is also a Sampradaya Acharya. Why he is doing such a thing? Everything is going nicely, smoothly, you know, Kamsa is also becoming a good boy, and suddenly he comes and he is making Kamsa angry, or he is planning like that. What is this? So we'll understand that later. What is Narad Muni's plan? So Kamsa is a dishonest person, and dishonest people cannot be trusted, you know. There is a very interesting verse in Bhagavatam. All of you know this verse. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagavatya kinchana sarveir gunes tatra samasate suraha harava bhaktasya kuto mahat guna manorathe na sati dhavato bahi. So we have to always keep in mind this verse. It's a very amazing principle. That someone who is not a devotee, he may have some good qualification, but still you can't trust him. Because whatever decisions he is making riding the chariot of his mind, manorathena. And the chariot of his mind, where he will take him, no one knows. Today the chariot is here, tomorrow it will be in some other planet. Today it is in goodness, tomorrow it will be in ignorance. So the translation of this verse goes like this. All the demigods and their exalted qualities such as religion, knowledge, renunciation become manifest in the body of one who has developed unalloyed devotion for Supreme Personality of Godhead. So all the qualities of the demigods, they are automatically manifest in a devotee. On the other hand, a person devoid of devotional service and engaged in material activities has no good qualities. Even though it may seem that, my God, this person is so polished and he has such good manners. So even if he is adept at the practice of mystic yoga or the honest endeavor of maintaining his family and relatives, okay, he is not a karmi, he is a yogi, or he is a karmakandi, he is maintaining his family nicely, still, and he is not a devotee, he can be trusted, he cannot be trusted. So even if someone is a yogi or he is maintaining his family in an honest way, he must be driven by his own mental speculations and must engage in the service of the Lord's external energy. So Kamsa is the classic case, and today 99% of the people are classic cases for this. How can there be any good qualities in such a man? So that's the situation of Kamsa. So we saw that Vasudeva is thinking that it's better that the sons would have died. So from this verse, Krishna is giving us a very interesting message. Krishna is a crooked person, so sometimes his message is also crooked, it's not very direct. Krishna is crooked. The way he looks, that is crooked. He stands in a crooked way. Vrindavan is crooked. The, you know, lanes of Vrindavan are also crooked. So, and the way he talks and his message, that is also sometimes crooked. So from this section, we get a very important message, which is not direct, but it is revealed to us by the Acharyas, that until everything is going on nicely, smoothly, you know, we are happy and no problem is there in life and happy-go-lucky and everything is nice. So till that time, Krishna will not appear. So when problem will come and we'll suffer and we'll cry, we'll be actually inspired to pray and then Krishna will appear. Till the time everything is nice and cozy, the Krishna, he does not appear. Prabhupada also writes that in one purport, few verses back. So Kunti Maharani also plays this famous verse is there. Vipadaha santu taha shashvat tatra tatra jagat guru bhavato darshanam yat syad apunar bhava darshanam. I wish that all those calamities would happen again and again so that we could see you again and again. For seeing you means that we'll no longer see repeated births and deaths. So Prabhupada says in the purport, Paritranaya Sadhunam, he is quoting that verse. So sometimes it feels Krishna is so wonderful. He is coming to make everything wonderful for devotees, you know. Paritranaya Sadhunam. When we'll come to Krishna consciousness, we'll be free from all problems. No more problems. First symptom of bhakti, kleshada. And once that happens, then I'm free, no more troubles. Then we'll enjoy in devotional service. So, but it's not like that. This Paritranaya Sadhunam has a very mystic message behind it. Or rather, Paritranaya Sadhunam will work only when something mystical happens. And that mystical is that when you will be put in big trouble, then that Paritranaya Sadhunam will happen. Till that time, it will not happen. So, till the time everything is fine, people are happy, Krishna does not appear. Now we'll see Narad Muni's pastime, his Leela, what he's doing. So these verses 62 and 63, which we are discussing here, Acharyas say that these two verses can be interpreted in two ways. Either you can interpret it as Shukadeva Goswami speaking to Parikshit Maharaj, or you can interpret it as Narad Muni speaking to Kamsa. These two verses. So either ways it can be there, interpreted. So now Narad Muni, as I described to you, Narad Muni wanted that Kamsa should kill the sons actually. He should not spare them. What is this? Let me go and talk to Kamsa and change his mind. So Narad Muni, actually he was roaming around in Meru and the demigods were having a meeting. This is all described in Garga Samhita. So, the demigods were hatching a plan that how to kill Kamsa and his dynasty and all the demons who are present there in Dwapar Yuga. And Narad Muni attended the meeting also. And then he saw that on the earth, Kamsa is sparing the children of Vasudeva. So immediately he comes and he thinks that let me leak the minutes of the meeting to Kamsa and let's see what happens. So, Narad Muni goes to one of the gardens of Kamsa. This whole pastime is explained in detail in Harivamsa. And he sends one of his Kamsa's assistants to tell Kamsa that, okay, I have arrived, Narad Muni has arrived, and he wishes to see you. So Kamsa comes there and he sees Narad Muni, who is shining like the sun, you know, resplendent like the sun. That's why the word Bhagwan is also used here for Narad Muni. He has all the six opulences like Supreme Lord. So after seeing Narad Muni, Kamsa worships Narad Muni in a very proper way. Just imagine, in those times, demons are also worshipping Narad Muni or sages. So after worshipping Narad Muni, then Kamsa asks Narad Muni. So Narad Muni, what is the news? You are famous for spreading news. So Narad Muni says, "Arey, very dangerous news. You don't know what's happening. You are in danger." So Kamsa is afraid. He already knows that this eighth child of Devaki is going to be born and he is going to be big danger for me. So so Narad Muni comes there. He is holding an eight-petaled flower. And he's holding an eight-petal flower and he asks Kamsa, so which is the first petal of the flower? So Kamsa says, this can be first. Or so Narad Muni says, sure, this is the first. So Kamsa says, no, that one can also be the first. You know? And so Narad Muni says, Baba, it depends on how you are counting from which is the first, the opposite will be last. So, depends on which is the first, you know, the first can be eighth also, and second can be seventh also. and seventh can be eighth also. So this is the crookedness of demigods. You don't know, I'm just coming from attending their meeting. So Kamsa says, "Acha, like that, huh?" So Narada Muni says, "Yeah, that's what I'm trying to tell you." So anyone can be the eighth son, you don't know. The first one can also be the eighth son. So Kamsa said, "Okay, don't worry, Narada Muni, thank you very much. And I'll make sure that all of them are dead now. I'll not leave any one of them." So here Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he gives 9 reasons why Narada Muni came and he did this, you know. Outside people, Karmis, they consider Narada Muni as a mischievous person. That's how he's portrayed in the movies. Now Narada Muni has come and now he'll do some mischief, some chugli will do. But Acharyas explain us why Narada Muni did like that. So Vishwanath Chakravarti gives 9 reasons why Narada Muni came and spoke these confidential words to Kamsa. So I'll just read it out, read them one by one. First is, Narada wanted to derive personal joy by seeing his Lord. He is eager that he should come fast, you know. Second is, to give joy to demigods by provoking Kamsa to violence against Devaki and Vasudev. So he wants to have joy himself. Krishna should come fast. Second is, he wants to give joy to demigods. Demigods' plan should be fulfilled. In the first canto, it is said, Indrari Vyakulam Lokam Vridayanti Yoga. So it is one of the primary reasons why Krishna appears, to kill the enemies of Indra. So demigods become happy. Third is, to accomplish the slaying of Kamsa for his violence to the devotees. So Kamsa will do violence, then he'll kill the devotees who are the sons of Vasudev, and his sins will increase. Fourth is, to shower himself in the intense devotion of Vasudeva and Devaki. He wants to experience the intense devotion of Devaki and Vasudeva personally by seeing them, by associating with them. Fifth is, to get their blessings, Devaki and Vasudeva's blessings, by delivering to them a confirmation of Krishna's appearance. How it will be confirmed? Kamsa will change his mind and he'll kill the sons. So Vasudeva will get the confirmation that Krishna is coming soon. Sixth is, to increase their eagerness to see the Lord. Vasudeva and Devaki, they already have eagerness to see the Lord. They have been practicing devotional service since 10,000 years of demigods in their previous lifetime. So now, you know, they are waiting. When will it happen? Seventh is, to drown them in an ocean of bliss by cutting down their doubts of whether the Lord would really appear. So actually, when Vasudev received his son back from Kamsa, he developed a doubt in his mind whether, it seems Kamsa is becoming a good man. So whether he's going to kill my sons, whether the Lord will appear, or who knows. If Kamsa becomes a good man, why should Lord appear? So to give a confirmation to Vasudeva that Lord will appear. Eighth is, to please Devaki and Vasudeva by making them blissful, even in those circumstances of suffering. And ninth, last, to make Kamsa favorable to himself by presenting false friendship. You know. So Narada Muni wants to present false friendship to Kamsa also. And the Acharyas explain that there could be a doubt in Kamsa's mind that this fellow Narada Muni, his associate of demigods, why he is coming and giving me secret information. But that is why the word Bhagwan is used to describe Narada Muni, because he is as good as the Lord himself, and whatever he speaks cannot be false. It must come to pass. So Kamsa has that much faith that if Narada Muni has said, it will happen. Also, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says that in this verse, the word Devata Praya, it means that mostly the Yadus, Vrishnis, and the followers of Nanda Maharaj. These three categories are described here. Mostly these three people were demigods. But some of them were demons also. Some demons had also taken birth. Jiva Goswami says in Krama Sandarbha that 5 or 6 demons had taken birth. So others were demigods. Of course, we know that in Lord's pastimes, various categories of devotees participate. First are the eternal associates of the Lord who are coming from Goloka. Then there are the devotees who have perfected their sadhana and they just need one more birth to get prema bhakti. So they also take birth. Then there are the sages who desired that they should associate with the Lord. They have taken birth. And then there are the demigods who take birth. So different categories of devotees, they take birth in Krishna's pastimes. So here Vishwanath Chakravarti is explaining how these two verses can be either Shukadeva speaking to Parikshit or Narada speaking to Kamsa. So if we say that these two verses refer to Narad speaking to Kamsa, then in this verse, Bharata is interpreted by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur like this. Generally, Bharata means the descendant of Bharat Maharaj, which is Parikshit Maharaj. Prabhupada also uses that in his translation. But here, few acharyas, they say that Bhara Bhara means ignorance, right? Tamas. And Rata means one who is engaged. So, one who is engaged in tamas is Kamsa. Like that. So, it's explained in various other scriptures about the celestial origins of the residents of Vrindavan, the Vrishnis, that is the family of Vasudev, and the Yadus, that is the family of Devaki. So it is said that, it's said in Garga Samhita that all the Vasus, they took birth as Gopas in the family of Nanda Maharaj, not family, in the society of Nanda Maharaj. Then all the demigods of the Swargaloka, they took birth as Vrushnis in the family of Vasudev. And one more category of demigods, I forgot the name, they took birth as Yadavas. So these different categories of demigods, they are taking birth in these three families. So here Narad Muni is saying that, my dear Kamsa, please be aware that demigods have taken birth in Vrindavan in the family of Vrushnis and also Yadus, and their only plan is to destroy you and all the demons. And don't think that only your opposition, in only your enemies or opposition, the demigods have taken birth. Even in your family, demigods have taken birth, like Akrura. There's example is given by Acharyas that Akrura was also one of the demigods. So even in your family there are demigods. Don't think that only in the opposite party there are demigods. So please beware. And please give them the same treatment which you give to demigods. This Narad Muni is speaking. What it means is that give the same treatments to all of them as the demigods. You hate the demigods. You want to destroy them, and all your associates like Agasur, Bakasur and Bhutnayan, etc., etc. They are, demigods are afraid of them. So the treatment which you want to give to demigods, please give the same treatment of torture to all these people, Rishnis, Yadus and the residents of Vrindavan. So also, our acharyas say that not only the human beings in these places were demigods, but also the animals in these places were coming from heavenly planets and they had celestial origins. The word cha used here in this verse, it says this, that not only the human beings but also the animals, they had celestial origins. So after understanding this, Kamsa goes back to Vasudeva and now he plans that, okay, now I'm going to take proper retributive action. I'm going to kill all the sons and no one should be spared. And I'm just waiting for the eighth one to arrive. And as soon as he comes, he'll also be gone. So in the next verses, we'll see that how inspired by Narada, Kamsa, he starts killing Vasudeva's children. So from verses 64 to 69, we'll see this. Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam Mahapurana Ki Jai.